The only thing I said so far is that this is the 11th session of this gatherings on energy that we have maintained with tenacity. Only 3 years after the COVID, we had to do it via computer, but we returned to do it personally, physically together. Well, the problem continues to be with us. We are making progress in some directions, but every problem that we do opens another difficulty, and we want to maintain very open that relation between problems and solutions at the same time. Today, the topic that you see is a very sophisticated topic, which is how do we treat the zero growth and CO2 at the same time that we continue producing industrialization in our own countries, with the relationship between the industry and the need to go to zero situation on CO2. Now, you know that there are countries that have reacted already. The United States has taken an important reaction with the IRA. And we cannot, as Europeans, get out of that movement in order to have the possibility of doing in parallel the two things. I have to congratulate very much the role of the Commission. I think that you are doing a very good job in trying to keep pushing. It is needed that the countries also react in a constructive manner. And this is what we're going to discuss today. We have two persons that are going to address in two sessions. The first will be started by you, and the second will be started by you, the presentation. Okay, without any further ado, I want to thank you very much for coming, for maintaining this this commitment of trying to keep on working on resolving this problem so difficult for the European Union, for our country. Okay, without any further ado, you start, and good. You come from relations with the bank and
So Javier, and so thanks a lot for inviting Inno Energy once again to support the Global Annual Energy Meeting. It has been always a pleasure and super important, this topic, but in the last years it has become really, really central. And it is true that we are living very challenging times. I think that in the last 15 months we have started the journey going through the whole energy trilemma. We were very focused on sustainability. Then the focus changed to affordability with the price, high prices of energy, and suddenly now we have turned into something that we had taken for granted for many years, which is security. So all this journey provoked by two main aspects. One has to do with the Ukraine war, and here I think that one of the main topics has been dependencies. We have started talking about dependencies, and the learnings is that somehow let's not substitute one dependency by another one. And I think that in the session today we are going to be talking a lot about critical raw materials, which is one aspect of it. The other aspect you were mentioning, Javier, has been the IRA. In August last year, the US surprises us with this Inflation Reduction Act, and now we are talking about protectionism. and the energy has become a central topic in terms of economy, and it is seen everything that has to do with climate tech and clean tech as the competitive instrument of all the different countries. So, as you mentioned, I think that as Europeans, we should be very proud of what the Commission has been doing, because in these two areas, one has been trying to reduce the dependencies, especially on the gas, and the other one has to do about how we have reacted to the IRA. And here we have different packages that they have launched, like the Temporary Crisis and Transition Framework, the Net Zero Industrial Act, the Critical Raw Materials Act, the Hydrogen Bank. So all these kind of measures, we are very happy because it has been a lot of flexibility and a lot of reaction in order to answer to the challenges that were at that moment on the table. As you know, energy, we have to say that we have been tempted by the U.S. because, you know, energy is—it has been for the last years the most active early stage investor in sustainable energy in the world. We have a portfolio of 200 companies, innovative companies, and 80% of them are industrial companies. So we like the hardware, we like the gigafactories, we like the manufacturing plants. And this implies that then the U.S. has knocked at our door and say, hey, come here. We have a marvelous situation. But we have said no. And we not only say no, but we do the talking, because our last massive investments in terms of industrial has been in Europe. We have we launched last year Gravity, which is a CO2-free iron. An investment mobilizing 2.2 billion. Olosolis, a 5 gigafactory PV plant, also last week it was announced in France, also in Europe, and an upcoming in the next weeks we will announce Fertigy, which is CO2 fertilizer company that is going to be also in Spain. So there are things to improve. Yes, of course. I mean, there is a lot of also financial gaps that we can do much better. We need more muscle, speed, and simplicity in the industrial policies in order to support the strategic value chains in Europe. It is true. But I think that we should be proud, because in Europe we have a stable regulation, which is a benchmark in the world in this topic. The society has some values that really going to sustainability is not a question, it's just how we do it. We have also finance. And the technology, we are at the forefront of the world. I mean, don't look at the other countries, because in topics like renewables, smart grid, storage, and mobility, the technology that we are patenting, creating in Europe, is at the forefront of the world. And we have an ecosystem, and this is this event is a sample of it. Joining forces is something that we need in order to move forward. So very happy again to be here, and looking forward for the discussion.
Thank you, Elena. Thank you very much for your determination. You never fail. the representative of the Commission in Spain, a few words to presentation, yes. Introduction.
Yeah, I will be very brief. Thank you very much, and thank you very much to Esade, Javier, Ángel. Javier, Ángel, Irene, all the team, because these meetings are broadly recognized and appreciated, so it's a huge privilege to be here today, and thank you for inviting the Commission. There is no doubt that maintaining the leading position of the EU industry and the net zero transition, it's absolutely key today. And precisely on what you mentioned, the regulation that we have, last week we celebrated the first anniversary of REPowerEU, which is, I think, a very smart and fruitful strategy towards the objectives and the targets that we have. On the funding side, that it was also mentioned, I think it's important to say that member states can include a chapter in the recovery and resilience plans, and this is something that we are looking at it now. As regards REPowerEU and transition and energy infrastructures, Since May 2022, we have indeed, in my opinion, made a huge progress in many areas. For instance, in the case of the dependency on Russian fuels, we can say we can proudly say that we are looking at the figures, and precisely on Russian gas today, only about 8% of all pipeline gas gas imported in the EU, down from historical levels of exceeding 40% in 2021, which is something, in my opinion, quite sizable. We are also launching the new LNG terminals, and this is something that it's also very important. And also on the energy savings, we are looking at the figures, and we can proudly say again that almost 20% of energy consumption by consumers are achieved. We are also growing on our own renewable energy basis by expanding wind, solar, hydro energy. Last year, for example, we generated more electricity from wind and solar than from gas. In fact, 39% of all our electricity in 2022 came already from renewables. So this, again, trying to summarize a little bit what we are doing, we are very clear on we have to keep our leading position industry-wise. We have to, of course, push for achieving our targets, and at the same time we have to find funding for all the investments that we need. So I think in general terms we are doing, it's bad that I say that, but we're doing a good job from the EU side. And I think that, of course, the collaboration and the partnership with industry is absolutely key. I'm, of course, looking forward to the discussions that we will be having today, and I wish everybody a very successful and inspiring event. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Okay, but then again, we start the formal session.